So my new e-bike just arrived. I'm checking the box out here. It looks like it's in good order. No issues, no spots that are wrecked up or anything. This bike is to replace my electric bike, which my husband now has. I had trouble getting my leg over due to a leg injury. So I'm hoping that this bike will do a better job. It's a step through. So let's go and unbox it. Okay, so here it is. It's opened up. Everything is packed good. Doesn't look like there is any kind of damage or anything. Okay, so we got it put together. It did not take that long except for one little part. Putting on, you can see right there, there's two, they needed an Allen wrench screws to put on these, their foot rests. One of them was stripped, so we had to take that out. Now I have to go and get a new one of those. But otherwise, it's set up really easy. We're just getting ready and going to take it out for a drive. This is my granddaughter trying it. She doesn't have her license yet, so this is kind of a nice way for her getting around too. We just drove it down to the highway and back, and whoever said it, it was an e-bike on steroids was correct. This is an e-bike on steroids. This thing is fast. I only had it at PAS 1, and I was cruising on it. And she's on PAS 1 right now too. I need to get on pavement before I try getting it on PAS 2 and 3. Well, it finally stopped raining and I can get out on the bike finally on the pavement. I haven't had a chance to even try it on the pavement. We live on the gravel road. And all I can say is I really like it. I'm doing 10 miles an hour right now. And it is on PAS 3 out of 9. I have it set up for the 9. Trying to think here. I did have it up to 28 with no problem, and then I backed off because I got scared. It probably would have went faster. But I'm kind of a slowpoke. I'm old. Anyway, comfortable ride. I did put a different seat on it. I have the Schwinn Cruiser, I think it's called. It's padded. It has a little spring in it. The front suspension on this is really nice. Shifts nice. I really can't find any flaw in it. It just seems like it's a good bike. It's well made. I did get it into my minivan without folding it. I just put the handlebars down, which I didn't even have to do that, but it just slid across. So I do have a bike trailer or a bike rack for it on the that goes on the back, but it's I have a different van and it's got the small hitch, so I have to get an adapter for that, and then I'll let you know how that goes. But I'm presuming it's gonna go just fine loading up on the bike rack. So that's about all I know. I
intersection. But no doubt in my mind that this will go up to 32 minimal pedaling. A well-made bike, the Yamee, I don't know how you pronounce it, LF750, 750-watt motor. I also noticed it's actually really quiet considering I'm got it going and got the throttle on. So I think it's a quiet bike. It's well worth the money. There's the review. I couldn't find any reviews in the YouTube, so I thought I'm just going to go ahead and make one for people that are interested in this bike. Thanks for watching.
On the road again. I just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again.